And in the year of 1848, God looked down on a little town called Oxford in Mississippi and said, "You need a companion." So God made Ole Miss. He said, "I need a place that will teach young students how to succeed in this world, have the best education available, and a place that will never leave the hearts of those that ever walk its grounds or pass through its doors." So God made Ole Miss. "I need a place that will stand tall through good times and bad, a place that will be able to withstand the battles of war and inclusion and acceptance and come out the other side a better place." So God made Ole Miss. God said, "I need a place that breeds champions, builds leaders, inspires greatness, creates families, builds champions again, and do all this while providing the number one game day experience in the entire country, a tailgating paradise for Rebel fans and opponents alike. No matter win or lose, they all stay till midnight." So God made Ole Miss. A place that can provide Oxford with new smiling faces each August and leave it, each May, better than they found it, with memories that will last a lifetime. It had to be a place that sent out its students into the world with a new greeting of "Howdy, howdy," spotting a fellow alum, no matter what was going on or where they were. Somebody who would wear the red and blue, no matter the score or the season, just to let others know that there was a friendly Rebel nearby. And then reply the smiling eyes when his son or daughter says they want to spend their life at the place Mom and Dad called home. So God made Ole Miss.